can you imagine people kill themselves every day and the statistics that were related to the social media? That wouldn't have been a statistic that existed 20 years ago.
Yeah.
But people today are killing themselves based off of interactions on Twitter or social media, including young people. So how do we mentor or guide young people around that? What actual conversations or things can we do to help them?
There's no perfect answer. I think for me, it's just understanding that social media is your friend, but it's also your enemy. You can use it to your advantage for whatever, good or bad, for entertainment, for information, for motivation. But you also need to understand that there's a dark side to social media. And it's just about letting people know that. You don't have to wait for somebody to get trolled. For example, how you tell the kids not to check or not to search yourself because you know that there's a dark side. So just to sort of maneuver in a way where it's not the be and end all, but use it when you want to use it. Use it to your leisure, but also understand that don't be on it too much or be mindful of the other side of social media, you know, because it's mad.
I'll just throw on them documentaries on Netflix. What's that documentary on Netflix?
The cats the plugs. Because I don't know them.
F with cats.
No, not even that one.
That one's mad.
Yeah, that one's crazy though. But there's a documentary on Netflix. I can't remember what it's called, but it basically, like, the people that used to work for all these social media platforms basically expose how social media manipulates you and the downside to social media.
I need to see it. So how, like, so I can share it.
The social
experiment.
Social Network's the movie, social right?
If you know it and you're listening to this podcast, please just post a comment. And yeah, just let us know what that...
Yeah. But one thing I learned from that documentary...
A whole operation, organization behind it.
Yeah. Listen, one thing...
The Social Dilemma.
That's it, Social Dilemma. That documentary, crazy. I feel like everyone should watch that to understand... Like,
you're part of something that's been...
And one thing I learned from that documentary is that Silicon Valley... Like all the people at the top that work at Silicon Valley, they don't allow their children to use like social media platforms and like they're not allowed to have a device, like a tablet, like an iPad or an iPhone.
Because they know
how much it affects
the detrimental effects of it. Yeah. Which is funny because then we'll be putting our child in front of a YouTube video for an hour of the day, and giving them iPads and saying it's good for them to learn. From early, but then
did you say for an hour in the day?
Morning. Yeah, is that too?
Some,
is that
some people give their longer children?
I feel guilty when my daughter's been watching CoComelon for 45 minutes to an hour. She ain't got no choice. She gotta watch it. I got stuff to do. I got work. But yeah, like I know you're right. Yeah. There's children that literally for like 6 hours
they have just the freedom of it. Use it when you want, or they use it to shut the child up. You know,
so Jamal, no, it's needed though sometimes.
Of course,
in the car.
Yeah, I understand.
Of course. But I think the bigger point is that, like, when you use it as a tool to teach your child, but not to talk to your child, like when it just becomes your child's life, it becomes the child's parent, the iPad.
Yeah.
It can be detrimental, and that's probably why they don't use it. It's kind of similar to the whole food thing. Many of the people that are like in charge of like the world food organizations, like the big companies, for examples. The ones that sanction what type of food goes, or even just the chain owners of like McDonald's and stuff like that. You think their children eat McDonald's and KFC? These billionaires.
Yeah.
No, we can eat it. It's for us, but that's not for them. And it's similar with technology as well. It's controlled and managed in a way that, like, you know, they've literally orchestrated this scenario. Yeah. Why would they put their own families at that situation? Yeah.